The Constitution of India. Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hi students, welcome back to our Computer Application Virtual Class. I hope you all are safe and healthy at home, right? And I am really happy to know that you all have completed your notes well, right? So as usual, let me share your healthy tip. Yes, see, wearing headphones for an hour could increase bacteria in your ear by 700 times. So if you are using headphones more than an hour, take a break while using, right? Okay, so let's start this class. Yes, so today's topic is e-waste, right? So e-waste means electronic waste. That means electronic, the waste of electronic products which we can reuse, recycle and dispose, right? See, 300 million of computers and 100 million of mobile phones are manufacturing every year. Yes, so after 3 or 2 years it will be unwanted. So what happens means it leads to increase in the percentage of e-waste. Yes, so in this topic we are going to discuss what is e-waste, then why should we conserve about e-waste and some e-waste disposal methods. So why should we concern about e-waste? Yes, see, e-waste is just not a waste. Yes, these products contain some toxic materials which cause healthy issues like cancer, right? So what happens to this e-waste means very small percentage of e-waste is recycling properly, but the majority is burned and dumped. But what happens means, again, it leads to soil pollution, air pollution, water pollution, etc. So for this concern, CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board, formulated a law called the E-Waste Rules 2011, right? So here, there are some e-waste disposal methods. Yes, so first one is reuse. Yes, so we can reuse the products. I mean, repair it, use it. Yes, then incineration. Okay, high temperature products burn chainadana incineration. Okay, burning these products at high temperature. Right, then recycling. Yes, recycling, manufacturing products, new products from the old one. Right, then last one, landfilling. This means dumping, but it is not recommended. Again, it causes soil pollution. Right, so these are the some e-waste disposal methods: reuse, incineration, recycle and landfill. Yes, so this is important. Right, then so what is students' role in e-waste? Namke endu cheyan pattum? Yes, first one, as I told you, pettanu kedu varumbothekum adu waste aagada, try to repair it. Right, and stop buying unnecessary electronic products. Right, and if you want to buy, choose the items which has good warranty or longer lifespan. Okay, yes. So next is green computing or green IT. Yes, designing or manufacturing electronic products with minimal or no impact to the environment. Yes, so it has some approaches like green design. That means designing eco-friendly products. Then previous class la suggestion parayunnu, previous class la oru tip parayunnu, aadita mouse wood undayirunnu. Yes, so again, so green design means manufacturing or designing products with eco friendly, right? Then green manufacturing means minimizing the waste materials while manufacturing cheyina samayathu undavuna waste inde alavu korakkanum. Then green use is minimizing the use of electricity consumption, right? Then last one, green disposal, again reconstructing or disposing in a appropriate way, right? So these are some approaches of green computing or green IT. Green computing means designing or manufacturing products with minimal or no impact to the environment, right? Yes, so far we have discussed hardware, right? So other than the input output prices, processes and e-waste purchases. Now next is software. Yes, again, what is software? So you have already learned in your lower sessions, right? So what is software? Software are the set of instructions which helps the computer to work, right? So there are two types of software: system software and application software. So let's see one by one. So next is system software. System softwares, right? So system softwares are the set of one or more programs that controls the operations of the computer system, right? Like executing programs, running programs, and communicating with other peripheral devices, etc. Right? So you can see the diagram. Yes. So far we have discussed about hardware. Yes, there. See, in this picture you can see the relationship between the hardware, software and the user. Right. So we have learned already about hardware. Now, what is software? Yes. And these three are the main components of software: operating system, language processors and utility softwares. Right. So, operating system. Again, it is a interface between the user and the computer, right? And what is the main objective of operating system is to make the computer convenient to use, right? And it is the first program that is to be loaded when you switch on your computer. Yes, so it acts as a resource manager of the computer system. Here you can see some examples: DOS, Windows, Linux, etc. So there are some major functions of operating system. First one, process management. That means it is the job of OS to manage each and every process, like scheduling or terminating programs that are under execution, etc. So process management is managing all the processes. Yes. Next one, memory management. It deals with the memory, like allocating and reallocating memory for each and every process. Right. Then file management means it deals with the file related activities like naming, storing, sharing, etc. Then last one, device management. It deals with the managing the device which is attached with the computer. Okay, like we have a printer option. Printer connected with the printer option. Our system, the printer has to print. So it passes some instructions. Right, so device management means managing the devices which is connected with the computer. So these are the four main components of operating system: process management, memory management, file management and device management. Right. Yes. Next is language processing. See, language is the medium of communication. Right. Yes. So in order to work with a computer, the user has to understand the language of computer. Yes, so there are some computer languages. See, low level languages and high level languages. Again, low level languages are two types: machine language and assembly language. So what is low level language means? Machine oriented languages. So the programs which are written by using the memory and registers of the computer system. So it differs for each computer. Right. So first, machine language means the program is written using binary digits. What is binary digits? Yes, zeros and ones. Yes. So machine language means the program which is written by using ones and zeros. That means binary digits. Yes. So here it is difficult to memorize the coding for long instructions. Right. So let's go for assembly language. Yes, assembly languages are intermediate level programming languages. Here it uses some codes like add, sub, and this is what mnemonics. Right. This language is called mnemonics, like add for addition, sub for subtraction. So compare. So when we compare with machine language, assembly language is much easier. But here also you have to memorize the codes. Again, it is difficult, right? Then next is high level language. Yes, it is like English language. Yes, so here it is really easy to understand. But the computer doesn't understand this language, right? So what happens is it requires a translator to convert this high level language to machine understandable one, right? It needs a translator for converting the high level language to machine understandable language, right? So here are the some examples of high level languages: Basic, C, C++, Java, etc. Yes, so language processors means translators which converts the high level language to machine understandable language, right? And there are three types of language processors: assembler, interpreter and compiler. Assembler is used in assembly language to convert the assembly language to machine understandable language, right? Then interpreter is, again, it is used in high level language. It converts the high level language to machine understandable one. But here it is line by line execution. So for example, 10 line endingil aadhyatha oru line endingilum error find cheythu kaniyana adu avana thana terminate, right? And it indicates the error. Yes, so once you rectify the error only, then you can move the coding, right? So that is what line by execution. Compiler is also used in high level language, but here it is entire program execution. Namme the coding edukkaneengil complete coding um kaiya sessione ivada execute cheyyum. So adile errors undengil it will show you the list of errors with line numbers, right? So that is the difference between an interpreter and compiler. So for an interpreter, example Basic, and compiler C++, Pascal, etc. So assembler is a translator which converts the assembly language to machine understandable language. Then interpreter and compiler both are used in high level languages to convert the high level language to machine understandable one. So, but what is the difference means, in interpreter it is line by line execution, and compiler it is entire program execution. So once you finish your entire coding, then only it will execute the program, right? So next is utility software. So set of one or more programs that manages, maintains and controls the computer system, like performing system maintenance tasks. Yes, here you can see some utility software functions. First one, compression tools. Yes, I know you have already know this, right? Namlu compress edu valiya videos okke ningal namlu ya compress edu. Yes, compression tools means compressing the file. Yes, to less the memory size, right? Compression tools are compressing your large files into smaller one to reduce the memory size, right? Example, WinRAR. Yes, then disk defragmenter. It rearranges the files. Oru file pieces aayitha pala sthalangal aayitha irikkum adu store cheyyunnathu. So here defragmentation means അത് റീഅറേഞ്ച് ചെയ്ത് ഒരു ഫയലിന്റെ എല്ലാ പീസസും ഒരേ മെമ്മറി ലൊക്കേഷനിൽ സ്റ്റോർ ചെയ്യുന്നതിനാണ് നമ്മൾ ഡീഫ്രാഗ്മെന്റേഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. സോ ദിസ് ഡീഫ്രാഗ്മെന്റേഷൻ ഈസ് റീഅറേഞ്ചിങ് ദ ഫയൽ. സോ വാട്ട് ഈസ് ദ യൂസ് മീൻസ് ഇറ്റ് മേക്സ് ദ കമ്പ്യൂട്ടർ ടു വർക്ക് ഫാസ്റ്റർ, റൈറ്റ്? ദെൻ ബാക്കപ്പ് സോഫ്റ്റ്വെയർ. വി നോ വാട്ട് ഈസ് ബാക്കപ്പ്, റൈറ്റ്? ഡ്യൂപ്ലിക്കേറ്റിംഗ് ദ ഇൻഫർമേഷൻസ്. നമ്മൾ വേറൊരു സ്ഥലത്തേക്ക് ഇൻഫർമേഷൻസ് കോപ്പി ചെയ്യുന്നതിനാണ് ബാക്കപ്പ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. ആൻഡ് വാട്ട് ഈസ് ദ യൂസ് മീൻസ് ഇൻ കേസ് ഓഫ് ദിസ് ഫെയിലിയർ we will not lose our data, right? And the last one, antivirus softwares. Yes, softwares which scans the computer virus and removes it, right? So these are the utility softwares. What are they? Compression tools, disk defragmentation, then backup software and antivirus software, right? Okay, so far we have discussed about system software. So what are the types? Yes, utility software, language processor and operating system, right? Now next is application software, right? Application softwares are the softwares which performs a travel, gym, payroll system, airline reservation, tally, etc. So these softwares are for specific purpose, right? So first, general purpose software packages. So the softwares which performs variety of tasks in a particular application area. Like for example, word processing software. Yes, Microsoft Word, OpenOffice Writer. Yes, so these are the word processing softwares. And what is the use? To create documents. Yes, and there you can add images, chart, map, etc. Right. So by using this word processing softwares, we can create letters, or you can create restaurant menu. Right. So there it performs variety of tasks. Right. Then spreadsheet softwares. Yes, it mainly performs calculations. Right. Okay. Here also you can add chart, map, etc. And here are the examples. So here are the examples: Microsoft Excel, OpenOffice Calc, etc. Right. So next one is presentation software. Yes. So presentation software is the software which we use to create presentations, like Microsoft PowerPoint, OpenOffice, Impress, etc. So we are making the presentation in a slide format. Right. Then database software. Yes. Here making the information in a tabular format. It is mainly to retrieving and storing the database information. Right. Then again examples: Microsoft Access, Oracle, SQL, etc. And the last one is multimedia software. Yes, multimedia means integrating all types of medias like audio, video, images, etc. Right. So again examples: VLC player, other media players. Right. Yes. So these are the general purpose softwares. Next is specific purpose softwares. It is only for performing specific tasks or specific use. Right. For example, payroll system. Right. So other employees the details store and other maintain cheyanam using the software on a payroll system. So it is only used for that particular purpose. Right. So specific purpose softwares are used only for specific purpose, developed only for specific purpose. And other examples: Tally, human resource management, etc. Yes, and it is mainly used to satisfy the needs of an organization or any institution. So softwares which are developed for a particular organization or institutions. Right. So those two are the application softwares. Right. Next is free and open source softwares. See, there are some softwares which provide you a freedom to use. Namukku use cheyam, copy cheyam and distribute cheyam. Anganeyulla chala softwares undu. Right. And so what, there are four types of freedoms. So those softwares provide you four types of freedoms. Like first one, freedom zero. You can run the program at your own purpose. Yes, namukku eppa vedavalli endinano, you can run the program. Right. Then freedom one means you can access the code. Yes, namukku aithe code access cheyan pattuna chala softwares undu. Yes. Then freedom two is to distribute the copies of the software. You can make duplicates. Right. Then last one, freedom three is you can improve the software. So namukku adhe coding access cheyan pattu engil you can improve it. Like you can make some changes in the coding. Right. So these are the four freedoms which provide you. This software is free and open source softwares. Right? And the next one. Freeware and shareware. Yes, freeware and softwares normal natural channel. Softwares download either you can use it unlimited period. Yes, unlimited period we use yeah, and it is a free of cost. So angana softwares are freeware softwares, but shareware softwares is like trial basis. For example, chela antivirus namma online la download cheyunnathu oru limited period ne namukku use cheyan pattullu. Then like oru purchase cheyyunnathinu munpu adine oru trial use pole. Right. So angana softwares are shareware softwares. Yes, so all the features of freeware softwares are free, but here all the features are not available. It is some limitations. And then freeware programs can be distributed at free of cost. So you can make duplicates, then you can distribute it. But again, shareware, it is not possible. Right? So these are some differences between the freeware and shareware. So freeware softwares are some softwares at free of cost and you can use it for unlimited period. But shareware softwares are like trial basis usage. Right? And next one is proprietary softwares. Like a property software, it is only used for them. Like namukku adine license illada copy cheyanu distribute cheyanu pattilla. So anganeyulla softwares are proprietary softwares like Microsoft Windows, yes, then Microsoft Office Suite, right, and Mac OS, right. So it is an exclusive property of the developer or the publisher. Right. Then next is humanware and or liveware. Yes, humanware refers the humans who are using, right, like programmers, system analysts, operating staff or other personal working of the computer system. So humanware refers those people who are working with the computer system, right. So I hope you have got an idea about the topics. So today we have discussed e-waste, then softwares, yes, application software, system software, then proprietary, humanware, shareware, etc. Right? So if you have any doubts, you can contact me. So copy this contents to your notebook and send it to me. Right? And practice the conversions as well. Right? Okay. So see you on the next session. Thank you.